Hello and good day everyone. I prepared this video so that we can still catch up on our lesson. Since I have some emergency and appointment to attend to, so which is it's very important to me. So I prepared this video in order for you to have the flexible time on doing this lesson that we have on our midterm, since next week will be our midterm exam. So I prepared this video in order for you to have a flexible time. Again, as I said a while ago, flexible time to have your lesson. I hope and all of you will just listen to this pre-recorded video that I prepared, so that you can have the free time. On your free time, you can open it on your stable connection wherever you are. So let's get started. So last time we already discussed the time complexity, no, of your code, no? So that if you try to observe, no? So we have different examples on our time complexity. So we will continue our discussion on the space complexity naman with regards to our lesson last time. So when you say space complexity during our previous discussion, so this is the amount of working storage, no, or algorithm needed or needs. When you say storage, it's not actually the actual physical form of the storage, no, such as your flash drive. HDD. When you say storage, is just a data structure that will hold your particular value in order for you to have your process to be finished. So meaning there will be some sort of a medium in order for you to store such amount or value with regards to your data, whatever data that you have. It can either be an integer data, it can either be a double or float data type. So this time complexity, space complexity also are based on the variable or the data structure that you are using with. Since program is relying on the variable or the data structure of your codes, meaning that the complexity or the space complexity are relying also on your variable or the data structure that you are declaring to. So meaning what would be the data type or what would be the variables that you are already used, no, together with the data type and the structure that you have. Space complexity also is go through with it, no? So let's try to have one example of the example number 4 that we have last time, no? So I'll just show it on the slideshow. Okay, so as you have observed, no? So just don't mind the other screen, no, on our data. Okay, so we have example number 4. We have ARX, no? then we have 33, 44, 55, 22, and 11 as our array index value. This is same also on the example that we have on the time complexity. Okay, moving on, we have also some variable as equal to 0. And then you have the loop statement, which is the for, which is I initialize to 0, then I less than n, and then I incremented by 1. And then also we have here the inside the loop, we are updating the variable sum, what would be the value of your arrx on the array bound or the array index value of 33, 44, 25, 22. So it will be updated on the sum. So meaning, kung if your sum is equal to sum plus arrx are not inside the loop, meaning this kind of expression will be counted as 1. Same with the sum is equal to 0. So meaning on our previous discussion, so the only process here that are visited once are the sum is equal to 0 and then the I is equal to 0, since we are only initializing the value as for the first time, which is equal to 0. So then the loop will just continue to increment depending on the condition that we have on our array. So array is not just fix a array index of 33 to 11, which is composed of index 0 until index 04. So if the array continues to added some value on the set of array list, so it will still flexibly continuously added also on the value of n, and then the increment will follow depending on the condition that we have until such time that the n is already satisfied. Okay, and I think you're already get that. So based on our example before, I mean the definition before, that this space complexity naman are relying on the variables and the data type that you have on your code. So since we have arr, sorry, it's a small letter, just corrected it. Okay, pag space ko nagano siya, naga capital letter A siya. So anyhow, so A will be our variable for arrx. So that will be our variable. Then next to it is the sum. Oh, by the way, the n here stated, the arrx is equal to n stated here, because we do not know what would be the last value of our n. So meaning, if you added another values here for our array list, meaning the n will also continuously added some value on our array bound, or I mean array list. So meaning the n here, meaning we would not know whatever the value that we have that can be added on our array list. So meaning kung ga-increase ang value sa ating array list, meaning ga-increase man ang value sa ating n. So that's why arrx is equal to the value of n. Okay? Then we have on the sum, since sum is already visiting only once, so meaning that is equal to 1. Okay, isa lang siya mag magamit. Okay, isa lang siya mag-visit natin. So that's why that is why I mean sum is equal to 1. Then for the I, since we have also the variable I, okay, which is also equal to 1. Okay, isa sa may initialize na, even though we don't know what will be the particular value when we stop, based on the array list, but still, ang condition natin, wala yaman yung ginatingog, inatag isa-isa yaman, so that is I is equal to 1 on the other. Same with the n, and the last variable here is the letter n, or the variable n, I mean. Ang n, although n is the determination of every array list here on inside the array, however, wala yaman niya ginavisit, tingog, ginavisit niya one by one ang kada array index nato. Kung matapos yung nag-visit yung isa, then another one. So that's why it is n is equal to 1. Okay? So si Ari lang git niya, ARX lang git ang n natin is because Ari can be flexibly add, can add another array list of value within the array. Excuse me. Okay? So we can say that we have n plus we have 3. Okay? Because we have n, yn plus 3, we have n plus the 3 values here of the 1s. So 1 plus 1 is 3. Okay. Then, same concept with our time complexity, we will remove the constant value. So, since the constant value here is 3, so we will remove 3. Okay? So, then lastly, based on our rule on the time complexity, same as on the space complexity, that we will compare. We will compare the highest order of the complexity. So since n doesn't have any comparison with the order, siya lang din ang nabiling. So we can say that the big O of this code is big O of n. So meaning ang for loop is the big O of your n. Okay, so that for example number, which is already discussed on our previous slide in the discussion. Okay, so that is the big O of your space complexity using this code. Okay, so let's proceed to another example. Okay, so we have a sum of equal to 0, then we use the example number 5 on our previous slides on the time complexity. Same man yung gapon niya code that we have on the on our example last time. Okay, so we have here, as you have noticed, so you have two for loop, the parent loop and the child loop, the child node of the loop, which is has a value of the variable of y, and for the parent loop, which is contains the variable of x. Then inside the child node, so we have inside the child loop, which is the y, dito na locate ang atong nga updating of the sum, no? Using the ARRX, no? We will just assume that the array, the ARRX, no? Does not have, no? Meaning may siyang infinite nga value, then it is already understood that the ARX again is your n. Na kay wait ka balo kung pila ka bilog ang content sang iyang array index value niya. No? So, we can say that the variables on your the variable ARX, no, as discussed to you a while ago. So these are the variables that we have, the ARX, the X, the Y, the sum, and the N. Okay, just check lang if there are some of the variables that are missing. But most probably all of the variables are already enumerated on this example. The ARX, the X, then the Y, the sum, and the N. Now, for the variable, for the value of your ARX, we have the n. So, syempre, it is very straightforward that since the ARX is inside the loop of the x, the y, Okay, so we have the equal to n. For the x naman, since x is, although they are separated from the parts of your for loop, but they are visited always once. No? Initialize always once. Ang condition ka, wala makakakondition. Tingog, kakondition ka man japon 1 by 1. And incremented again plus 1. So that is the x meaning x value 1. Same with y, we have value 1. And then although sum is inside the loop, but is the sum is being updated, no? Every time that the loop is being, I mean the loop is being executed. Meaning ang ato ni nga sum niyo, naga-update ni siya. No? Each and every time that the loop is being conditioned, and at the same time the iteration is being executed. So meaning if the condition is not yet satisfied, the iteration is I mean will continue. So meaning ga-update ang atong sum. Ga-update man sa. So meaning ga-visit sa once each and every time that the loop is being executed. So meaning that the sum is equal to 1. Ang n ang moment. Ang n nato naman niya ang equal sa 1 because although it is inside the loop naton, wala man siya, as I have said a while ago, as I mentioned to you, wala man siya nag-execute tingog. Ina-execute yung man niya one by one. Pero syempre, hindi talang siya, hindi talang siya makita again physically because we are the time complexity is already fixed na no na computer sa. So meaning ang n natin, even though it is part of the loop, ang loop naman niya wala man siya nagasiling dinatingog ko na siya ano, dinatingog ko na sa fetch tapos i-rect ko sa isa ka variable. No. Ang variable niya ang fetch niya gina 1 by 1 niya man. From the initialization of the value, then it will condition gradually until such time that the condition is being satisfied. So these are the variable that we have, and at the same time the value that we assign to, knowing how many times that the variable is being executed and visited. So we can say that the n is plus 4 since we have 4 variables here that contains the value of 1. 1 plus 1, 2 plus 1, 2, 3, 3. So anyway, do ka straightforward naman ang iyang approach. So isa lang si n, tapos may 4 ka 1. Now, again, we will go back to the rule. We will remove the constant, which is 4. Now, then we can say that this example number 5 is the big O of n. Okay? So, manang iyayang na pertaining to with regards to our example. So, I hope your the discussion here is very good. Now, the question behind this assumptions of sir gina ano ta pagina sir na determine tagid ang iya time complexity and what are those equivalent of the big O and what are the equivalent of the big O n to or any value that refers to the big O. So these are the big O measures of efficiency. Since we are on the computer science, our objective media is to optimize, no? To optimize our code so that the load with regards to the instruction set of your memory and their processor should be lessened. No? Though amo na ato yung pinaka main point, no? Just imagine bala guys, so when you are creating a system and then isa pa lang ka form, it will take time to process your expression, your formula, your execution. it will take latency of the process para maka-come up sa isa ka output, no? Which is on the side of the project management, it's very not normal or butantabi, no, in a vulgar manner, it is abnormal. Okay, ang mga ang obra sang aton, no, nga field is to consider also the specification of the unit nga gina-installan ta sang aton yung mga system or programs naton, no? Because reality bites that not all, no, that not all of our of I mean of the organization can afford, no, those kinds of specification with regards to your system. Kung dagko a company, probably it can be, no? Or they can afford to upgrade, or somehow they can afford to buy, no, those kinds of specification. Now the bigger question is, how about those na hindi ka afford? So that's why we optimize our codes of our program. We sum it up, no, as much as possible, the 100 line of codes, ihimoon ta na sa 20 to 30 line of codes, we can do it. Oh, I mean, we need to do it because that is our call, no, na para ma-optimize ang aton niya na program para magjutay ang load sa aton niya na system, no, sa isa ka. And these are the constant, no, as you have observed here, no, ang pinaka fast naton, ang pinaka slow, the high time efficiency and the low time efficiency. Now as you have observed here on the name description of each measurement of the efficiency, kung ga-declare ta mga constants, no, such as I is equal to 0, sum is equal to 0, num is equal to 1, so they are the high or fastest measure of efficiency. Kaya syempre wala mo sila may ginagamit na mga iterations or anything, maski mag-ano ka pa mag-give statement ka pa. They are the fastest notation with regards to the measurement of your efficiency. No, time man siya or either space ka complexity. Now, when you are using the logarithmic, no, notation naman, so they can produce at least microseconds of the logarithmic. Magamit ka sa mga logarithmic naman siya if we have data that contains matandabi mga classes, no? Mga modules, no? Kaya na breakdown niya into some sub-program, and then connected only into one main program. Gusto niyo ang iya nga processing niya, wala na tingob lang sa isa lang ka file. No, so which is ang gina-adapt mo. But we are using the object-oriented programming para mag-lessen ang load natin sa memory. Okay, just imagine bala, no, if you have 2,000 line of codes and you hamper it only, no, encode mo na siya into one particular sequence of algorithm. So, basahon niyo kaya from line number 1 up to the line 2000, no? So sa line 2000 na included na lang for loop, including the while, do while, kung ano pa ida mga loop na pinapanggamit, eh, kag mga constant nila, mga variables, data structure. So medyo may ano gyud siya. May ara siya ginatawag na complexity with regards to the processing. Okay, now if your big O notation encounters O n, now which is sa itong mga previous time ko na result, it will produce 0.1 seconds niya nga, I mean, excuse me, measurement of the efficiency measure. Okay, so for the linear logarithmic naman, so amo naman na saya ang combination of different loop statement or iteration, which is a combination of your urinary ng mga symbol. Now, let's say for example, one of the example of the urinary symbols are, example lang niya, so we have plus for example equal to 2, or can put it like this way. Ayan. So medyo may complexity na mag-isa when it comes to the code. It's because you are using the so-called combination of the loop statement with a certain amount of numbers with regards to the skipping of iteration. Kaya normally ang gagamit kumagamit tayo incrementation or either decrement, so syempre gaano taga minus 1 or plus 1. However, if we encounter, for example, na may mga simulation tabi ng mga makita, no? or design simulation na nag-encounter yas ang skipping of number of 2, skipping number of 5, no? Which it's I think it's very normal naman sa aton yung mga code niya may mga may mga alteration man sa aton yung mga skipping of numbers, no? With regards to iteration, so we call it linear logarithmic. So gagamit na tayo sang other way around in order for us to achieve a same result. However, we are considering the high time efficiency and at the same time the fast and slow with regards to the measurement of the efficiency of your machine. Kaya nga, tundi guys, nga after is ang machine ta dapat ya, dapat ma-satisfy tagid niya, dapat hindi siya mag-hinder man sa iyang na specification ng machine. Because as I said a while ago, ang mga machine taya or mga company hindi man niya ka-afford sa specification niya ginapangayo normally. E kung ka-afford sila, then most probably it's good. But the question kung hindi ka-afford ang company, kung ka-afford ang company, at okay lang kung hindi. So that's the very challenging on our part, on how we optimize those codes that we have, especially right now that we are using UI UX na gagamit tas ang mga different DLL na gagamit tas ang different mga API na regarding the application that we are using also, provided ko naman ang mga programming languages so that we are encounter or ang ginagamit again na medyo komportable kami gamit. So, kagamit sa mga other parties with regards to our code. So, syempre, consider naman yun ang mga machines. No? So, that's why, as a computer science student, we need also to consider and the measurement of the efficiency of the, the efficiency of your code para mag-compatible na siya sa efficiency sa inyong machine. Yeah, probably later on yung magamit sa company. Okay? Then we have quadratic, no? Atong din pang mention ta a while ago, niya big O n squared. So it estimated time na is 15 to 20 minutes. Then for polynomial, so we have 10. Okay? So medyo lawi-lawi siya, no? Per hour. Area gagamit niya kung ano nagit, kung tama nagit kabalki ang iabala guys na processing sa ang iyang processing not only on the code but also on the other aspect of the of the machine. The like, na nada si, ano, si my server, hosting, web hosting, domain, IP address, so video, ano gamit siya. Kung ga-backup ka, doga, ano, sa dog, doon nag-change ang iyang na latency of time. Then we have exponential, no? Then intractable. Then we have factorial, which is also intractable. Okay. So that is the continuation of our lesson last night, no? With regards to the space complexity down to the last slide. Okay. So this will be also the coverage of our exam with regards to our lesson for today. I will be uploading this presentation to our GC. Okay? So stay safe everyone, especially stay hydrated with especially on this time of the weather that we have now in the Philippines. Okay? I'll see you guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.